These stories are inspired by the actual case files of the Office of Scientific Investigation and Research.
Boss!
We're heading back.
Yeah, I'll be there in a minute.
Something wrong. It's getting dark.
Come on, you sucker! Come on, let's move! Let's go!
Jeez.
Damn tree huggers.
There is a well-known legend about giant ape-like creatures roaming the woods of the Pacific Northwest, walking upright and exhibiting a high degree of intelligence. Sightings, photographs, film and video footage, as well as footprint molds and hair samples, all comprise compelling evidence that might indicate the Sasquatch could really exist. A man-beast, not quite simian and not quite human. Something strangely in between.
We gotta punch our way to the ridge before first snow, and that idiot's gonna put us way behind schedule.
Jacko probably just got drunk as a politician and wandered off, boss. We've all been up here too long.
Yeah, well, we ain't going home till the job's done, tree huggers or not.
Over here, boss!
You got him!
Jacko? Jack? Jack?
Ah, I'll kill you, son of a bitch!
He's alive, boss.
Looks like he ran into a little present from our protesters. Cut him down.
I saw it right here. It came right up to me.
You saw what, Jackal?
The Bigfoot! Right here, real as goddamn life!
Hey! There's nothing funny here. I swear to God, if you've been boozing again, I'm gonna ship you back to Nelson tomorrow.
I'm not lying, boss. It came right up to me, growling. It must have been 7 feet tall if it was a goddamn inch.
Hey, boss. I think you better take a look at this.
I told you! Real as goddamn life!
Don't anybody touch anything. The company's going to want to look at all this.
Case file number 260140, case manager Connor Doyle. We've arrived at a remote road building site to investigate several claimed sightings of a humanoid animal in the area. Our objective is, if possible, identification and observation of the creature.
Well, that certainly was a nice situation.
Always is when big business meets Mother Nature.
Come on, they're just building a road to access a hydro dam 200 clicks east.
Oh, just a road through the last pristine habitat of several species.
Advanced security reports say that the conflict is intense, but so far peaceful.
So the company's bringing in more lawyers! The cops weren't enough! Save our trees! Save our trees! Save our trees! Save our trees! Save our trees!
I tell you, Professor, you're on a fool's errand, and you're not the only fool around.
How long have the protesters been here?
Right about a month after we did. Chained themselves to trucks when we tried to get in here to set up camp. They haven't gone since, and I don't expect them to either. Now they're putting spikes in trees.
See, some of the more radical environmentalists are putting iron spikes in the tree trunks to stop chainsaws.
Rips the chain right off in mid-cut. Jacko hit one the night that he saw the creature.
What exactly did you see when you were out there looking for Jacquard?
A big animal walking upright through the trees.
Was it a bear, perhaps?
I don't know what I saw. I didn't get a good look at it.
But you all saw something.
Gentlemen, nobody's come this far into the valley to build a road before. The hydro company asked me to find the toughest team of workers I could find. Half of them wanted to go on that day. I had offered them bonuses just to stick around. What the hell else was I going to do?
Damn tree huggers. They laid that trap for me. And trust me, you don't want to be hanging from a tree like some fool when that thing comes looking for dinner.
So it came right up to you?
Like a Kodiak bear wanting to rip your head off. Except no bear I know looks at you straight in the eye like this one did.
It didn't attack, it just left you alone?
I was so scared I must have passed out. Must have thought I was dead or something.
Jeez, I haven't seen one of these since I was in the Boy Scouts. Poor bugger hung here for 2 hours. Well,
at least he's alive.
Yeah, it's a professional job. Whoever did this knew what they were doing.
And had a size 28 shoe.
Well, those are big tracks there, LQ.
Yeah, but... Look, I studied these Bigfoot tracks from all over the Pacific Northwest. I've never seen this before.
What, tracks this big?
No. Two distinct sets of tracks in one place. Could be there's more than one creature out here.
Oh, boy.
I'm not buying it. The Bigfoot is just a hoax cooked up by the construction company to scare us off. It's just fiction.
What about something cooked up by you to scare off the road crew?
Look, I would never risk our movement's credibility like that. We're gonna win this battle through protest and raising awareness. Hearts and minds, Professor.
The foreman, Rehnquist, claims that your people planted iron spikes in the trees. Destroy their equipment.
No one in my organization was stooped that low.
What about someone outside your organization? We don't work for Rehnquist or the company. We're independent.
All right. There were two wingnuts we tossed out 3 weeks ago.
Where'd they go?
Deeper in the bush. If anyone's seen your beast, it's them.
Seems Brad and Nancy are pretty adept at living off the land.
I bet they haven't gone too far.
Far enough.
Good instincts.
Okay. You've got our attention.
Are you Brad Harper?
Stay right where you are.
We just want to talk, that's all.
We've got nothing to say to you.
Relax, Brad. They're just Bigfoot hunters.
You don't seem surprised to see us.
I figured Mullen would crumble under any pressure, so we have to be careful out here.
What exactly are you doing out here?
Those Hydro Nazis are trying to destroy this forest. We're going to stop them.
By any means necessary.
Yeah.
Those Planet Alert wimps were going nowhere. At least out here we can take the fight to them.
Brad, Planet Alert would prefer to write pamphlets and sign petitions while the ecology of this whole region is being raped. We're making a stand out here.
We're not here to take sides.
Hey, if you're not part of the solution.
We're here to do research, that's all.
Research is why they put the road up here.
This is sacred land. Home of the Chehalis tribe, home of the Sasquatch. No one's supposed to be here.
Physiological and psychological tests of the witnesses reveal nothing to suggest that they're lying about what they saw.
Although Brad and Nancy wouldn't cooperate, I wouldn't be surprised if they didn't trust their own mother. They're so paranoid.
Regardless, we still have enough circumstantial evidence to move forward under the assumption that someone or something is even deeper in the woods.
Well, we lifted casts of two sets of prints. Both of them are too large to be any animal indigenous to the area, and they're definitely not the bear family. They're closer to primate in bone structure.
Cooper, what is it?
These two tracks differ in detail, though that they're very close to other Bigfoot prints we've seen over the years.
Are they both real?
Both prints indicate a human-based walking style, impossible to replicate without real movement.
We've also collated all the Bigfoot information gathered over the last 50 years. It seems there's two rules about the creature. One, it's a hominid of unknown species. And two, it's always been spotted alone. We got two sets of tracks here. Well,
unless it's a male and a female pairing, or it could be a mother and her offspring.
What happens if you cross into its territory?
It could get ugly.
Axon, this is Doyle. You copy?
This is Axon, I copy.
What's your position?
200 meters west of you and closing. No readings on the scans.
Hey, Doyle! I got motion ahead. Through the trees, faint. Moving at 10 kilometers an hour.
Human?
Maybe. 2 meters in height, 3 meters, I can't get it fixed.
I need a medical team.
I saw it.
We're gonna get you some help.
I saw it. I saw it.
Check the tape. Case log update. After coming across an injured environmentalist in the nearby woods, we've secured video footage which may help reveal what is roaming the forests in this area. The witness, Nancy Byatt, remains in shock in our medical lab.
It appears authentic. We sent the original back to HQ for verification.
Any sign of her friend?
Nothing. He's either gone, or he knows these woods better than your average bear.
Well, what about Nancy? Can't we regress her, find out what happened?
According to our psychologist, her current state of shock would make regressing her dangerous. We have to wait till she comes around and get over whatever it was she saw.
Footage suggests that she was filming one creature when a second one attacked her. Now, we tried to enlarge some of the images, but they're too grainy to identify anything.
But we did find more prints at the site, both light and heavy.
You know what might help is an aerial survey of the terrain. Get a better idea of what's on it.
Get started on it. I want to look into any Aboriginal legends surrounding this creature. They may help us explain why this is happening. We need some answers soon.
Something in the tool shed.
Jacko, give me the gun.
Boss.
Mm-hmm.
is gonna push my schedule back at least another month. Damn Green Movement punks. The cops are gonna come and get them today.
Think protesters did this?
What are you saying, it was a creature? Because I ain't buying it.
Well, I don't know. You said you saw it yourself.
Look, I saw something.
We gotta hunt it down. It's coming into the compound at night now. Just a matter of time before it comes into the camp, rips one of us apart.
Jocko, the company says...
Oh, the company says! Look, the company sent us into this creature's territory. And if we ain't leaving, then let's at least hunt it down.
Nobody's hunting anything down.
Oh, is that a fact? Well, tell me why not, science boy.
Because you don't have a hunting license. Now this is our investigation. We will decide how to proceed. You let us handle it. Not bad, huh? Almost case manager material.
Unless, of course, they find out all we have are tranquilizer dart guns.
Professor, talk to them! If they move us out, they can do anything they want to the forest.
I have no mandate to interfere in this dispute. I'm sorry.
You know we didn't do this.
But to the police, you do have a motive. You want to see the construction of the road stop.
You're right. I'm not sorry about the damn construction equipment, but we had nothing to do with it. The innocent always get blamed for the sins of the rich and powerful, Professor!
Give us a second.
If there is some kind of creature out there, I hope they march right into its face.
Why?
Trees can't fight back. Sounds like this thing can.
Stories? Well, the stories say that Sasquatch lives in the hidden ground. The sacred ground, where even the Chihalis can't go. He's supposed to be the spirit of a great warrior. He helps the forest survive by protecting it from people like me.
Do you believe these stories?
Hey, I got mouths to feed. I need this job. I might be a little out of touch with the traditions of my tribe, but I'm a good father, you know? I mean, these stories, they're supposed to be just that. And every now and then, you gotta wonder that maybe a story exists. Because what it's saying is true.
Whatever he saw has caused him to reassess his entire belief system.
Connor, how old is this Chihalis legend?
It's ancient. The Chihalis aren't the only North American tribe with a Bigfoot legend. I think it's significant to note that almost every culture has some mythical creature that acts like a missing link between them and their proto-human ancestors.
The aerial and environmental assessments show a limited amount of animal life to sustain a creature as large as the one we're talking about.
Yeah, if the Bigfoot is as large as we suspect it is, it would have depopulated the entire area if it only ate meat. So it's probably an omnivore. Eats anything and everything.
What about the creature's movement?
Well, there are a million places that they could hide or roam about freely without being detected. These patterns here indicate an area where the foliage is less dense.
You know, Peter, it is possible for an animal this large to create worn-down paths. Well, or patterns of movement, at least.
This would be a good place to start looking.
Testimony? Tracks? It's hard to dismiss this as a long-time hoax.
The rate of Bigfoot sightings in this part of North America is the highest in the world.
So, do we accept these ancient warnings of a man-beast guarding the forest?
If we heeded every ancient warning, we'd be out of a job pretty fast, wouldn't we?
More tracks, leading north.
Heavy or light?
Light and heavy.
Like we found our legend.
Too late by the looks of it. It's not quite as big as I thought it would be.
Cooper,
is it?
It's human.
Fake?
Oh, great.
His tactics got him killed.
And what threw all that heavy machinery around? What attacked Nancy?
It was probably the same thing that killed him.
Well, whatever it was bigger than him. A lot bigger.
It was Brad's idea. He knew someone who could make the suit. It was the perfect way to get rid of the construction crew. He thought that if he could make a video and leak it to the media, they'd back off. I was filming Brad, and this animal burst in from the right, hit me across the face. I don't remember what happened next.
Final case log entry. After Nancy Byatt emerged from her state of shock, we were able to learn what we had suspected since we first encountered her and Brad Harper in the woods. They had executed a hoax to try to scare off the construction crew, with tragic results. Harper's fatal injuries appear consistent with an attack by some predatory creature, most likely a grizzly bear. Ironically, due to a prolonged delay in the completion schedule, construction has ceased indefinitely in the region. As to the evidence suggesting a second larger creature, no further traces were found. Connor Doyle, out.
As nature retreats before man, new insects and even mammals continue to be discovered. In 1995, a hitherto unknown species of deer was found in an isolated area of Vietnam. Findings like this clearly mean that we should not cease our search for elusive, mysterious, and possibly very genuine primal creatures. Perhaps the Sasquatch is another unknown animal species whose existence is only waiting to be verified.
So you think I could have been a king or something in my past life?
We'll see, Mr. Lindenauer.
Yeah, right. If I was a king, I'm sure I was a real nasty one. Probably did all kinds of bad things to people.
Now, why would you say that?
Must have done something to deserve all the crap I've had to live with, right?
I hope you're doing this because you think it's going to help you, not because it'll give you an excuse.
Well, to tell you the truth, I'm doing this for Annie. She's become obsessed with it since she's had it done. She's really the only thing in my life that means something.
It's my fifth birthday. My parents are there, blowing out the candles on my birthday cake. They're not watching me. They're fighting. They're yelling loudly. Everyone's watching them. No one's watching me.
I want you to go back farther now. Go back to when you were just 2 years old. What are you doing?
Playing in the kitchen. There's a kettle whistling on the stove. There's no one there but me.
Relax, Garth. You're okay. Everything's okay. Relax. I want you to go even farther back now, to the time before you were born. Go back, Garth. Back. Farther. Where are you?
In the hospital room.
What's your name?
Ian Vetamani.
How old are you?
I'm 80.
Do you know what day it is?
Chicken salad for lunch. It's Friday. Friday, July 13th.
What year is it?
2040.
Are you sure?
Absolutely. It says so right there on my comm screen. July 13th, 2040.
Okay. Let's go back farther. Go back to 1995, October. Where are you?
Walking down Michigan Avenue in downtown Chicago.
pretty good day outside. Got about 20 minutes to my next meeting. Just checking myself out in the window of my office.
Past life regression under hypnosis has been explored by some therapists with varying degrees of success. Now, in this research, some people claim to have traced back and discovered who they might have been in a previous incarnation. But what if hypnosis revealed a parallel existence? Explaining this perplexing phenomenon was the challenge in the following case of two men who seem to be experiencing intersecting lives.
A lot of the guys think I'm running some sort of circus sideshow here.
Now, how long have we known each other, Lisa? About 10 years? For my money, what you do is very important and legitimate.
You'll see. He can predict the future. New world order, people flying around on anti-gravity devices. Regress him, you'll see.
You said you haven't told Mr. Lindenauer about the unusual nature of his past life.
No, I thought it might be damaging to him.
I agree. I would like to keep this investigation covert.
Well, I'll simply tell Garth that Anton's an old colleague who's interested in the regression procedure.
Well, we do use brain mapping technology.
Don't worry. Lindenauer's not the type who asks too many questions.
Good. Anton will inform you about the rest of our procedures. Let's get started this afternoon.
What year is this?
2001.
Who are you?
Ian Vitamani.
Where are you?
See bars. In jail.
Why?
5 years ago, I was an investment broker. I made a few personal investments that went sour.
That's not illegal.
Well, it is when you borrow your client's money and invest it on your own behalf.
This Vetamani sounds like a real swell guy.
You mean Lindenauer actually remembers being Vetamani?
Anton regressed Lindenauer backwards through his own life into what should be his past life. And yet somehow, he's able to remember what is actually the future.
Okay, I want you to go back even farther. Back to 1995. It's the fall, the leaves are changing, and it's the morning of October the 26th. What's happening?
Listen to the radio on the way to the office. Major earthquake in Chile this morning. Panthers beat the Leafs 6-1. Oh, man. I'm in trouble.
Why?
Goal took another nosedive. Wasn't supposed to happen. Marty told me it was a lock. Damn it.
Okay, Garth. I want you to wake up slowly. And when you do, you're not going to remember anything that we've talked about.
I knew I should have made that bet. 6-1 Panthers, just like Lindenauer said.
Ian Vetamani is alive and living at 355 Armory Lane, Chicago, Illinois. He's 35, married, no children. He's an advisor at Tillwood & Brock, a mid-sized investment firm.
This came over the wire service. A quake measuring 6.8 on the Richter scale hit Santiago, Chile, just about an hour ago.
We could have warned them.
But there's no way of knowing that the information we had would be correct. Nor can we say if it would have been right to act on it.
How can you say that?
If Lindenauer really can see the future through Ian Vetamani, we could be getting into a very dicey situation.
Without wanting to sound overly dramatic here, we could also be on the verge of discovering the very fabric of our existence.
I'd say that was dramatic.
We'll proceed very slowly. We must all understand the dangers of knowing the future. We can't possibly predict the consequences of altering the events.
Case log update. After completing 15 sessions with Garth Lindenauer, we've discovered there may be three intersecting lives. We're proceeding to attempt contact with Ian Vetamani. We're hoping to lure Vetamani into a regressive hypnosis session in the belief that understanding the connection between these two men is the key to something even greater than we may have suspected.
That's him.
Double check all online. Copy that.
You guys getting this back there?
Video link is up, and I have visuals on Vetamani.
Take Lindenauer back to the present day in Vetamani's life and have him recount exactly what's about to happen.
All right, Garth, let's go back to October 1995. It's October the 27th. It's in the afternoon, and you're walking down Michigan Avenue.
On about the 2300 block, headed toward the newsstand. Man, gold went down again. If it doesn't turn around soon, I'm fried. If I could just get my hands on a little more cash flow, I could climb back on top of things. Of course, there's always Trisha's jewelry.
Who's Trisha?
Oh, my spoiled, rotten witch of a wife. Man, something tells me I'm never going to own one of those now.
What?
The blue convertible just drove by. Oh! Man, I'd trade Trisha straight up for one night with her.
Yeah. You're right, Mr. Lindenauer. She's hot.
What a charmer this guy is.
Vetamani or Axon? Okay. I'm going in.
Hey. Good luck.
Just what I need, a fresh sucker.
If he bleeds green, I can climb back into the black. Looks uptight. Well, what are you gonna do? Beggars can't be choosers.
Ian Vethamani, you have made the right decision coming to Tillwood and Brock. Come on in. Actually, you're lucky, Dr. Thompson. Normally, I wouldn't be able to squeeze someone in at the last minute, but I just happen to have a cancellation, so I...
Mr. Vethamani, I'm not here to make an investment. You've been randomly chosen to be part of an experiment on stress in the workplace.
Excuse me?
You will be paid if you choose to participate.
Now, I want you to move farther into the future. Slowly, just a few minutes at a time. What's happening?
I'm being arrested.
What?
I knew it. I knew they'd catch me. They're handcuffing me.
Donner Axon here. Lindenauer's saying that Vetamani's gonna be arrested in approximately 10 minutes.
If Connor gets in the way, he could change everything. I've gotta warn him.
I think that's a good idea.
Long-term projection is really, to say the least, quite stable and...
Excuse me. Dr. Thompson here. I see. Okay. Yeah, I see. Yep. All right, sorry. Something really important's come up. We'll have to get back to this another time.
When?
I'll get back to you.
How much were you gonna pay me for that experiment thing?
Thanks for your time. I'll be in touch.
You know, this deal closes this afternoon. If you're to miss out... You know, you could just write me a check and I can get the whole thing started today.
I'll give you a call.
Well, thanks for coming in, and don't forget to... Oh.
Dipstick.
Can I help you?
Good morning.
Hi.
I'm here to see Mr. Vetamani.
Certainly.
After they handcuff you, what's happening?
Leading me out through the office. It's humiliating. Everyone's staring.
Really gotta look at these stock options, Charlie.
Oh, yeah. Running down the stairs.
What do you mean?
Those two guys at reception, they were cops, I know. They're around earlier asking questions. They're after me.
I thought they handcuffed you and were leading you out.
No, that never happened. I saw them coming. I'm getting away. I think I lost them.
I was afraid of something like this.
Connor, the experiment we planned never involved helping Vetamani escape from the police.
Well, we didn't actually help him escape.
No, but if I hadn't left Vetamani's office as the police were arriving, he never would have seen them coming.
But now, according to Lindenauer's memories, Vetamani is no longer caught by the police in the future.
Did the change in Vetamani's life have any ripple effect on Lindenauer?
Are you suggesting that they could be linked karmically? That somehow Vetamani's life could change Lindenauer's?
I'm just considering all the possibilities.
I interviewed Lindenauer extensively after the session. As far as I can tell, he left Dressler's office the same man that went in. Well, as far as we know, the arrest in Chicago never happened.
What the hell have you done to me?
Garth, what are you doing?
I'm gonna kill you both for screwing up my life. What the hell are you really doing to me under those sessions?
Garth, what happened to you?
Annie left me.
Why?
She saw me for what I really am. And she was right. I'm a loser. And I always have been.
No, you're not.
I'm not, huh? 2 hours after Annie walked out on me, I got laid off. And one day, what little life I had has completely fallen apart.
There are too many coincidences. The changes in Lindenauer's life must be affected by the change that we made in Vetamani's life.
Are you saying because he never gets arrested and atones for his crimes, Lindenauer suffers the consequences?
Exactly.
If there is some karmic connection between the two, then why wouldn't the changes in Lindenauer's life be retroactive?
What do you mean?
I mean, once Lindenauer's past life was altered, then his entire life should have changed right from the day he was born. But it just seems to have taken a downward turn since yesterday.
What if the past is written in stone and can't be changed?
Well, Lindenauer remembers Vadamani's future changing.
Yes, but perhaps the future can change because it hasn't actually happened yet.
Well, how is it that Lindenauer can see the future through the eyes of Vadamani if that future hasn't happened yet?
Well, maybe Lindenauer can't see the future. Maybe he sees a future. What he sees can be altered. He sees possibilities, premonitions. It's like he has a clairvoyance specific to Vadamani's life.
It's an interesting theory.
So we can all agree that Vetamani's life seems to directly affect Lindenauer's, right? That also sounds like a relationship consistent with certain aspects of reincarnation.
If that is the case, then how is it possible that they could both be living at the same time?
I want this investigation shut down.
I can't do that.
You defined a direct order.
We may have significantly altered a man's life. However unintentional it was, I think we have a responsibility to try to fix the situation.
The downward turn in Lindenauer's life could have been coincidental.
It's possible. There's too much at stake, too many unanswered questions. I strongly recommend not closing the investigation now.
I'll give you 24 hours. Bring Lindenauer into the loop, explain everything to him. If he's willing to take the risks, you may proceed. But be careful.
I assure you, we'll do our best to consider every potential outcome. Take every possible precaution.
We'll be watching you carefully.
Let me see if I get this straight. This Vetamani guy is my past life, but he's actually alive right now.
That's right.
Now, how's that possible?
We don't know.
But you think that what happens to him can change my life?
Do you know what karma is?
If you can catch Vetamani and make him go to jail like he did before, then Annie will come back to me and I'll get my job back.
It might not be quite so cut and dried.
We're not sure what'll happen, but you may be able to help us catch Vetamani.
He is a wanted criminal.
It's pretty wacky stuff. What have I got to lose, right?
At the bank, I'm opening the safety deposit box.
There's bonds and jewelry. The last of everything we've got. Trisha's gonna go ballistic. I wish I could see the look on her face.
Alpha team to base, we're ready to move.
Base over.
You were right about Vetamani. He's laying low. He's on his way to the First National Bank. And according to Lindenauer, he's gonna empty out the contents of his safety deposit box.
Where's Vetamani gonna be in 15 minutes? Garth, let's move ahead a little bit. It's been a few minutes since you emptied the deposit box. Where are you?
In the parking garage. Getting into my car. I can't believe it. I actually think I'm gonna make it.
What level are you on?
Four.
Ian Vedamani, step out of the car. We'd like to speak with you for a moment. Get out of the car. Investigator down.
Unit 1, we need an ambulance stat. Investigator down.
I didn't mean to hurt her. Is she okay?
She's dead.
I didn't mean to hurt her. Is she okay? Sorry.
Doyle, we have a problem here. Doyle, do you copy?
AXA, you're breaking up. Stand by.
Ian Vedamani, step out of the car. We'd like to speak with you for a moment. Get out of the car.
Okay?
Yeah.
Nice dive.
Oh, thanks. It helps when you know what's gonna happen.
Doyle?
Yeah, we're fine. Lindenauer was right. So are you.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hurt anyone. I swear.
We have Vedamani.
Thankfully, Lindenauer's version of the future can be changed.
Garth. When you wake up, you're not going to remember anything that happened in the last 3 days. This is what you will remember. You came to see Dr. Dressler for regressive hypnosis therapy. That was 3 days ago.
We turned Vedamani over to the Chicago authorities. He's being held without bail pending trial.
He seemed extremely remorseful. In fact, he's vowed to pay back all the clients that he stole from.
Yes, quite often criminals harbor an enormous feeling of guilt for their crimes, but they won't actually admit it until they're caught and forced to face what they've done.
Headquarters has officially ordered us to close all investigation into this case.
What, that's it? We're just heading home?
Let's stick around. I want to see what effects we might have caused.
She said that our time apart made her realize that she couldn't live without me.
You really look terrific, Garth.
Yeah? Look at this.
Hi, Annie.
Hi, Dr. Dressler.
Garth, where did you get the money for this?
After Annie came back to me, we took one of those personal investment courses you see all the time on TV together. I made a bundle on gold futures. Believe that? Jump like me?
How did you know to invest in gold futures?
I don't know. It just kind of came to me out of thin air. I don't know what I did to deserve all this, Doc, but I'm not complaining. Thanks. See you.
Did you guys get all that?
Further research by the OSIR uncovered a third intersecting consciousness that Garth Lindenauer and Ian Vedamani shared, a young boy living in Australia. What could be the determinants behind this kind of existential cross-circuiting? A function perhaps of powerful random telepathic transmission? Or maybe as the population of this Earth plane expands, there just aren't enough souls to go around. One thing is certain, Garth and Ian were connected by a bond that drastically affected their lives, past, present, and future. Perhaps we all share a similar connection.